Thank you, and thank you very much. First of all, I want also to join my voice for the words of thanks to you and excellent organization of this 25th meeting of OSCE, and express the readiness to work with Miroslav Lajcik in his upcoming OSCE chairman in office. Dear colleagues, of course, my statement will be mostly dedicated to the same ideas which was reflected in them, a lot of statements which was done before me. And first and utmost is existing conflicts in the OSCE area, which is for sure remain the most serious threat to peace and security. First and utmost, the principal position of Azerbaijan is running in line with the norms and principles of international law, and particularly in respect of states' territorial integrity and sovereignty within their internationally recognized borders. Since our last meeting of the Ministerial Council in Vienna, so far, we still have not seen no concrete progress towards resolution of the Armenian-Azerbaijan conflict. The fundamental principles of inadmissibility of use of force for the acquisition of territory and ensuing obligation of non-recognition of situation resulting from serious violation of international law and refraining from rendering aid or assistance in maintaining this situation regretfully are applied selectively by mediating countries. In the meantime, we witnessed consistent attempts by Armenia, with active support of the diaspora worldwide, continue to unlawful practice of alerting demographic, cultural, and physical character of the occupied territories of Azerbaijan, infringing upon the human rights of hundreds of thousands of forcibly displaced Azerbaijanis, including the right to return to their homes of origin. In flagrant violation of the 1949 Geneva Convention and additional protocol to it, Armenia has continued illegal resettlement and other activities in the occupied territories of Azerbaijan. The unlawful action of Armenia, including illegal military and civilian build-up in the occupied territories, demonstrate its intention and systematic policy aimed at consolidation of the occupation and imposing a fait accompli. These steps undermine trust in the peace process, especially in view of the failure to dispatch an assessment fact-finding mission to the occupied territories of Azerbaijan due to the refusal of Armenia. Relevant UN Security Council resolutions, principles of the Helsinki Final Act, and decisions and documents of OSCE form the basis for conflict resolution for mandate of the co-chairman of Minsk Conference. The United Nations Security Council resolution of 1993 demanded immediate, complete, and unconditional withdrawal of occupying forces from all the occupied territories of Azerbaijan, and as a reciprocal step called for the opening up communications and transportation links and urged assisting the return of internally displaced persons to their homes. The underlying concept of this approach is based on removing consequences of the conflict while differing remaining political issue for follow-up negotiations within the Minsk group. Azerbaijan believes that there is no alternative to peace, stability, and mutually beneficial regional cooperation, and is the most interested party in the earliest political settlement of the conflict. The resolution of the conflict is possible only on the basis of the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Azerbaijan within its internationally recognized borders. The military occupation of the territory of Azerbaijan does not represent a solution and will never produce a political outcome desired by Armenia. I'm glad also to inform you that yesterday we have with co-chair and Armenian foreign minister very intensive consultations, very important exchange of views, and it was, I consider, very useful. We, for the first time within the years, can manage to agree on the text of the joint statement of the OSCE Minsk group co-chair countries and the foreign minister of Armenia and Azerbaijan. One of the major points is even more intensify result-oriented talks, including of the high talks on the high level. I believe that whenever elections will be over in Armenia and they will be settled the new government, we must, for the next year, making a breakthrough and building up a good opportunity for bringing peace, stability, and prosperity to the region.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.